name above all names, name above all names. You are worthy of praise, and my heart will sing how great is the God. Your name above
just lift up the name of the Lord high. He is a great God. He is a great God. He is a great God. He has been so good to us. He remains good in the morning. He remains good in the afternoon. He's God in the evening. So we just want to lift the name of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
You are good. And your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You are good, and your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
You are good, and your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
I see it every day of my life. Your mercies, you are good, and your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Sing with me, you are good, and your mercy is forever. Your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
I give you praise. Yes, Jehovah, you are in my life the most high God. Oh, Jehovah, you are. Oh, you are the most high God. Yes, in your life is the most high God.
Great things. We worship you this morning. We worship you. We glorify your name. We exalt your name. There's none like you, Jesus. We thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Reke tarabasa haya, rebona rabaria rabasa handa rabasha ya, mrete rebele bosa, rabena rabena shia rababasubiena rababasete ya, mureke tarabasa. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, Lord of Lords, thank you, thank you, ya babasa handa rabasha. Mureke rebele bosa, 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 mureke glorify your name. We are worthy to be worshipped. We are worthy. We adore you this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. There's none like you, Lord of Lords, King of Kings. I honor the tribe of Judah. We worship you. We thank you.
We bless your name, Father. This morning, we honor your name. We glorify your holy name. We thank you, oh God, yes, for watching over our lives, for watching over us. Lord God, our strength and our refuge. We want to worship you this morning. We want to honor your name. Lord, even as we continue to give glory, even as we continue, oh God, yes, to give glory unto your name, even as we continue, Father, to bow down before thee, we thank you, Father, for ministering unto us. We thank you, Father, for ministering even unto our deeper and inner needs. We bless your name, Father, God of our Father Ezekiel, in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Father, for making it possible for us even to gather together, even, oh God, to come together on this Zoom meeting, Lord, for the purpose, oh God, yes, of praising your name, for the purpose of worshiping you, for the purpose, oh God, of hearing from you. Thank you for loving us. Thank you, Father, for embracing us. Thank you, Father, even for your divine hand in the name of Jesus. Thank you for manifesting forth your glory in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, who has exalted your name above your word, we thank you, Father. Yes, Father, thank you. Yes, in the name of Jesus, even as we prepare, Father, to hear from thee. Thank you, Father, yes, for speaking unto us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We want to thank God so much this morning. Thank you, the Ndanga family, for leading us in praise and worship. We want to greet the Church of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to welcome each and everyone. Welcome to our young generation, the youth who have been leading us this week. We say God of Ezekiel continue to increase you and bless you in our midst. Again, we want to welcome our pastor, Pastor William Chindu, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Today is a special day. Today is a different day. God has favored us by giving us a choice servants whom he has anointed specifically for us today. We have got in our midst all the way from Scotland, Scotland province, all the way from up north. We have got our overseers, overseers Gomba Komba, who are with us. I want us to unmute give a shout, urulet unto the Lord, even as we welcome our overseers, Morris and Betty Gomba Komba, who are with us in Birmingham. Shall we put our hands together, even as we welcome them unto the gospel platform, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory, 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 glory.
Glory, glory, glory. Wonderful.
We bless the name of the Lord. Yes, God has afforded us this time to hear from the anointed vessels who speak the gospel, and we have got insight, a different insight, as we shall hear. Over to you, overseer.
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor. Are you hearing me?
Yes, indeed, we are hearing you.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's my great honor today to share the word of God with the Birmingham region. I want to extend my greetings to our overseers, our pastors, elders, and deacons, and the Church of God this morning. Thank you so much. People of God, let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity, for this time, oh God, to hear your word. Holy Spirit, help us to understand your word. In the name of Jesus, take over now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Today I want to share with you about the power of the word of God. The power of the word of God. I have this book with me, written by our father, Dr. Ezekiel Guti, The Integrity of God's Word. The Integrity of God's Word. He says here in this book, the word of God is sincere. The word of God is honesty and wholesome. Sometimes people, even believers, they take the word of God for granted. And yet God's word contains all we need. Sometimes people, even believers, they take the word of God for granted. And yet the word of God contains all what we need. So I have constructed my message from this book. The power of the word of God, the integrity of the word of God. Today, we are going to run down a number of scriptures. I want you to write them down and take them home. Right, our main text today is Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, a well-known scripture. The Bible reads, for the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts. The word of God is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Another version, Amplified, says, the word of God is living and active and full of power, making it operative, energizing, and effective. It is sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating as far as the division of soul and spirit. The completeness of a person and of both the joints and the marrow, the deepest parts of our nature, exposing and judging the very thoughts and intentions of the heart. The word of God is a discerner. The word of God is living. The word of God is powerful. The word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. So today, we want to explore the Bible together about the power of the word of God. Here, the Bible is clear, saying to us, the word of God is living. The word of God is powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. The word of God is the discerner of thoughts. So John chapter 15, to those who are writing, you can write John chapter 15. You can start from verse 1 up to the last verse of this chapter. It's a powerful chapter. But today I am going to read verse 3 to verse 5 and verse 7. The Bible reads, as I said, we are going to read a number of verses. Then we go like that. Verse 3 says, you are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Verse 4 says, abide in me and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless abides in me. Right. Branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. Right. Verse 5. I am the vine. You are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Verse 7. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask anything you desire and it shall be done for you. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire. When the word of God abides in you, you will ask anything and it shall be done for you. When you are full of the word of God, you shall ask anything. Which means when we ask something to God, he will check the word in us. When the word of God is full in us, we are assured to ask and receive the answer. When my word abides in you, and you will ask anything, and I shall do it. It shall be done. When the word is in us, the answer answer is inevitable. When we ask of him, the answer is inevitable. Right. John chapter 14. As I said, we want to read a number of verses. Then we go. Sometimes our father says, it's better you read the word of God. Read the word of God. Because the word of God is powerful. If you believe the word of God, when we read it right now in this service, believe that something is happening in your life, because the word of God contains power. The word of God is active. The word of God is alive. John chapter 14, verse 23-24. Jesus answered him, if anyone loves me, he will keep my word. If we love Jesus, we keep his word. And my Father will love him. And we will come to him and make our home with him. Are we together? Right. If anyone loves me, he will keep my word. And my Father will love him, because that person keeps the word. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home, The Bible did not say, and make our house with him, but make our home with him. A home refers to a location. A home refers to peace. So, verse 24 says, whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. And the word that you hear is not mine, but the Father's who sent me. Anyone who keeps my word, my Father will love that person. And we will come to him and make our home with him. Right. John chapter 1, verse 1. Just write them down as we go. John chapter 1, verse 1-3 and verse 14. Hear this. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God.
Amen.
Verse 3. All things were made through him. Through him, the word. All things were made through him. And without him, nothing was made. Verse 14, hear this. And the word became flesh. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. And the word became flesh, and it dwelt among us, and we beheld his his glory. The word became flesh. Everything was created by the word. Don't take the word of God for granted. Everything was created by the word. According to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3, by faith we understand that the universe was created by the word of God. The universe was created by the word of God. God created the universe with words. The word of God is God himself. You did not hear me. The word of God is God himself. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. The word of God is God. The word is Jesus. The word is Jesus. Verse 14, and the word became flesh. The word is God himself. The word is Jesus. So when, if you fail to believe the word of God, you fail to believe God and Jesus. Here, the word is Jesus. Revelation, according to Revelation chapter 19, verse 18, he is clothed, the word says, he is clothed in a robe dipped in the blood, dipped in the blood, and the name by which he is called in heaven is the word of God. Is it there in your Bible? Revelation chapter 19, verse 18. He is clothed in a robe dipped in the blood, and the name by which he is called is the word of God. He is called the word of God. Jesus in heaven is called the word of God. This word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. When we do not believe God's word, it means we do not believe God himself, and we do not believe Jesus himself. God and his word are one. God, Jesus, his word, the Holy Spirit are one. God's word is holy. God's word has undeniable, irrefutable, indisputable, incontrovertible, reversible power. The word of God has undeniable, irrefutable power, unresistible power. The word of God has indisputable power. The word of God has incontrovertible power. We need to believe the word of God. Learn to believe the word of God. The word of God is powerful. The word of God is honesty. The word of God is sincere. All our needs are fully supplied in the word of God. You did not hear me. I said, all our needs are fully supplied in the word of God. What I need to do is to find them in the word of God and possess them and possess my needs.
Amen.
But they are fully supplied in the word of God. They normally say, what is given is not automatically yours. You need to possess. If you read the word of God, God said to the children of Israel, I have given you the land. I have given you the land. When they got there, when they were in the promised land, they were some Jebusites, Gergesites. And we hear the same God who say to them, I have given the land for you. And he said again, possess the land. How can I possess a given land? Because in the given land, they are Jebusites, they are Gergesites, they are giants in the land. So you need to possess. I am saying all our needs are fully supplied in the word of God. I need to identify them and I need to possess them. Hallelujah. People of God, the word of God, all our needs are fully supplied. They are fully paid for in the word of God. I need to possess in the name of Jesus. Therefore, we need to learn to speak the word of God. We need to learn to believe the word of God. Don't take the word of God for granted. There is power in the word of God. Right. As we continue, we need to have a deeper understanding of God's word. A deeper understanding of God's word. The word of God will endure any amount of pressure we may put upon it. You did not hear me. I am saying the word of God can endure any amount of pressure we may put upon it. The word of God can stand it. The word of God can endure it. Learn to speak the word of God. Learn to pray the word of God. Some people, they pray other things, but learn, when you pray, learn to pray the word of God. When you pray, learn to pray the word of God. Learn to speak the word of God. Align yourself with the word of God, because the word of God is God himself. The word of God is Jesus. The word of God is powerful. The word of God is pure. The word of God can endure any amount of pressure I may put upon it. Come with your sickness in the word of God
and lay it upon the word of God, and the word of God will stand it. Come with your situation. The word of God will stand your situation. Any amount of pressure we may put upon the word of God, the word of God will stand it. The word of God will endure it. The word of God will succeed it. In the name of Jesus. Are you hearing me? Let's go together. Don't be left behind. Let's move together. The word of God. Psalms 119, verse 8 and 9. The Bible reads, Psalms 119, verse 8 and 9. Please write this down in your notebook. Have this verse in your notebook. Psalms 119, verse 8 and 9. Hear this. Forever, oh Lord, your word is firmly fixed in the heavens. Your word is firmly fixed in heaven. Right now, as I speak with you, the word of God is firmly fixed in heaven. Another verse says, your word, Lord, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. It will not move. No one will shake it. You only shake it when you confess, when you declare, when you speak it. If you want to shake the heavens, speak the word. In the name of Jesus. One other year, at another assembly, we were still new at that assembly. We went there on the 31st of December. The next day, it was 10 days. So we were in the 10 days prayer in the evening. I heard somebody was praying with a loud voice, lifting up chairs, praying. And he started to say, God, I can't put it in English. God, I cannot reduce God to Mutandawe Baskoro. God is more than that. People of God, when you pray, speak the word. If we want to shake heavens, we need to speak the word of God, because the word of God is firmly fixed in heaven. Right, another version says, forever, oh Lord, your word is settled in heaven. Your word is settled in heaven. And another, that's why people, they failed to destroy the Bible. The early church, they try to destroy, to burn the Bible. And up to now, there are some people, they try to burn the Bible. We cannot destroy the Bible, because the Bible, the word of God, is firmly fixed in heaven. Oh Lord, another version says, oh Lord, your word is established in heaven forever. Your word is established in heaven forever. So if we want to shake the heavens, we need to speak the word, pray the word, dream the word, eat the word, read the word, speak it, read it, speak it, read it, read the word. Hallelujah. Speak the word. There is power in the word of God. Oh, yeah. The word of God contains life. The word of God contains life. According to John chapter 6, verse 63. John chapter 6, verse 63. It is the spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit. Jesus said, the words I speak to you are spirit. I'm not just speaking. The words I speak to you are spirit. Right now, the word of God I am speaking to you, it's a spirit. Connect your spirit to the spirit of the word of God. Connect yourself to the word of God. And Jesus said, and they are life. They are life. The words I speak to you are spirit, and they are life. I am speaking life to somebody. I am speaking life to the church of God. The word of God is a spirit. When you want to understand the word of God, you need to be in the spirit of God, because the word is a spirit and the word is life. The word of God provides life. The words of God provides life. Some people, they ignore the word of God. When you preach to them, they ignore to them, and they did not know. They don't know that they are ignoring the spirit. They are ignoring their life, their lives. People of God, the word of God is life. The word of God provides life. And the word of God abides forever. No one will shake the word. The word will stand forever. Move with me. I'm sure we are together. Don't be left behind. The word of God abides forever. According to Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8. Another powerful scripture. Write it down. The Bible says, the grass withers. The grass withers. The flower fades. But the word of God stands forever. Flowers wither. They fade. But the word of God stands forever. The word of God will never fade. The word of God will stand firm forever. The word of God will endure everything, and the word will stand forever. So you need to abide to something that will stand forever. Our riches, they are going to fade one day. Economies, they will shrink, but the word of God will stand forever. People of God, learn to put your trust in the word of God. Don't put your trust in your money. Don't put your trust. Those years, I was a millionaire. I had $1 million in my account. Somebody blessed me with $1 million. $1 million, Zimbabwean dollar. Those years, somebody blessed me with $1 million. But all of a sudden, economy changed. And my money, because of economy, I couldn't do anything with it. People of God, we need to put our trust in the word of God. When you put your trust in the word of God. The word of God will stand forever. The word of God will stand forever. It's good to trust your husband, but don't put all your trust. One day tables will be turned around, but put your trust in the word of God. In the word of God. Don't rely on your friend. Friends are good, but sometimes they desert us. But put your trust in the word of God. People of God, yes, we need friends. Friends are good, very good. They will help us. But don't put your trust, because the Bible says people are people. Our father said people are people. They can change at any time. They can change. But put your trust in the word of God. The word of God will stand forever. The word of God will stand forever. Everything can be shaken upon the earth, but God's word will never change. God's word will never change. If you can see what is going on in the world, disasters are happening around the world. If you put your trust in your house, one day you woke up, your house is not there, but put your trust in the word of God. With a house, without a house, I put my trust in the word of God. I know the word of God will stand forever. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me, Church of God? If you are hearing me, say amen, overseer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Good, 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 wonderful. Let's continue. The word of God will not pass away. The word of God will not pass away. According to Matthew chapter 24, verse 35. Matthew 24:35. Mm-hmm. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will by no means will not pass away. My words will not pass away. Are you hearing me, Church of God? The word of God will not pass away. The word of God, the word of God is not designed to return to God void. The word of God is not designed to return to his owner, God, empty, void. But the word of God was designed to accomplish its purpose. The word of God is not designed to return to God void, to return to God empty, but the word of God is designed to accomplish whatever it came for. The word of God is designed to accomplish its purpose. According to Isaiah 55, verse 11, Isaiah 55, verse 11, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and it shall succeed. The word of God will succeed. The word of God will accomplish its purpose. The word of God will succeed in the name of Jesus. The word of God is not designed to return to God empty. No. The word of God will accomplish its purpose. The word of God will succeed. If you are not feeling well, continue to put your trust in the word of God, and the word of God will succeed. Don't waste much of your time talking about your sickness, because the sickness cannot change the word of God, but the word of God can change sickness. The word of God. Don't continue. Don't spend hours speaking about your bad situation. Your bad situation cannot change the word of God. But when you speak the word, spend more time speaking the word. I know the word will change my situation. The word will succeed. The word will succeed. The word will succeed. The word will succeed. They said, you have cancer. Oh, mama. Believe the word. The word will succeed. The word will succeed. Learn to speak the word. Learn to obey the word of God. It is the word of God that it teaches us to pray. When you see us praying, we are obeying the word. It is the word of God that it teaches us to love one another. When you see us loving one another at our local assembly, in your church, we are obeying the word of God. When you see us loving our enemies, we are obeying the word of God, because the word says, love your enemies. When you see us loving our enemies, we are obeying the word of God. When you see us forgiving other people, it doesn't mean we are dumb. We know what we are doing. We are obeying the word of God. When you see us forgiving other people, we are obeying the word of God. When you see us giving in church, we are not just giving, we are obeying the word of God. When you see us rejoicing and things are not okay, no, we are obeying the word of God, because the word of God says, rejoice. And I say again, rejoice. When you see us doing what we are doing, we are obeying the word of God. My dear brother, if somebody stands and announces that we are no longer praying, we don't listen, because we obey the word of God. When somebody stands up and say, hate your enemies, we say, no, I obey the word of God. When somebody says, this one did this to you, you need to revenge. You need to do something to show that you are there. No. We obey the word of God. Sometimes when you see us speaking with the seasoned speech, we are obeying the word of God. My dear brother, obey the word of God. Some people, they have a tendency of reading what they want to hear. They have a tendency of listening to the preachers. They have a tendency to listen to the message they want to hear. My dear brother, sometimes if the message is from God, it will not go in your favor, but you need to obey the word of God. Obey the word of God. Learn to obey the word of God. Are you hearing me, Church of God? The word of God that contains all what we need. The word of God contains within itself the power to create, the word of God contains in itself the power to create. When you speak the word of God, you are speaking creative power. You are using creating power to this afternoon in the name of Jesus. If you believe the word, something gonna come on your way. There is power in the word of God. The word of God is our source of everything. The word of God, our source of everything. Salvation, our salvation is in the word of God. Our rebirth in the word of God. Eternal life is in the word of God. Healing is in the word of God. Do you know that doctors, they don't heal, they cure, but the word of God heals all our diseases. In the name of Jesus, there is healing in the word of God. One other year, somebody was tested cancer. In the doctors, they wrote a report to him, to that lady. It was a lady. And they said, you are not going to make it. I don't think you are not going to pass 3 months. You will be dead. They signed. They wrote what they have studied. But the word of God can turn tables around. In the name of Jesus, the word of God has a creative power. And we were called. We went there and we shared with her about the word of God. He sent forth his word and the world healed them. And the word saved them from their destruction. The way he sent forth his word to heal, to deliver, to save from our destruction. The word of God is powerful. Then I said, if you believe that the word was sent to heal us, which means the word of God is our medicine. So I am going to give you a prescription. I said in the morning, take 2 tablets of the word of God. And in the afternoon, take 2 tablets. And in the evening, take 4 tablets. And then 1 injection on top of these tablets. Take them every morning. Take them in the afternoon. Take them in the evening. And take your injection. She took the tablets of the word of God. After some time, she went back and they tested. They said, we are seeing some developments. The word of God can bring development to a damaged body. In the name of Jesus, right now as I speak, she is still alive. I am sure 8 years ago, and recently, another one was tested cancer, and we gave us the word of God. Learn to believe until they wrote a letter to that lady and said, you are cancer free. There is power in the word of God. I told you another story of that lady who was tested HIV positive. We also gave her the tablets of the word of God. And after the husband died because of HIV, and the lady was positive, full-blown AIDS, and we gave her scriptures, the tablets of the word of God. The word of God is not designed to return to its owner void. And she took the tablet. After a week, rash popped up on her face, and she went on a mirror, and she started to say, "Devil, you are a liar. Rub off your rash." After 2 days, there was no rash. Continue to eat the word of God, taking the tablets of the word of God. And after some time, we said, go and be tested. She went and be tested, and the results came. The results said, you are negative. She couldn't believe it. And she called us, she couldn't believe it. She went for another test, and the results came. She was negative, and she gave a testimony on Ezekiel TV. I am saying the word of God is not designed to return to its owner void. Believe the word. There is deliverance in the word of God. There is sanctification in the word of God. There is inheritance in the word of God. There is spiritual growth in the word of God. Even our faith, even to have faith, to believe the word of God, faith cometh by hearing the word of God. Faith is in the word of God. People of God, the word of God is our source of everything. In my conclusion, as I am rounding up, as I am concluding, as I am finishing, we are going to finish with Jeremiah chapter 1. It's a broad subject. We cannot finish it in a day. So people of God, as we conclude for our first message of the word of God, Jeremiah 1, verse 12, a powerful verse. Write it down, write it down, write it down. There is power in the word of God. Are you hearing me, church of God? The word says, then the Lord say to me, you have seen well. Jeremiah, you have seen well. You have seen right. What you saw, that's it. He said, for I am watching over my word to perform it. Jeremiah, what you saw is right. What you have seen, that's it. I am watching over my word to perform it. The eyes of God are on the word of God. The word of God is our mirror. If I put a mirror in front of me, I see myself. And if I put a mirror to God like this, God will see himself. So if I lift up the word of God to God, God will see himself. God will say, yes, it's me who wrote it. It's me who said it. And he is ready to perform it. God is watching over his word to perform it. The eyes of God are on the word of God. So learn to speak the word of God, because the word of God is like a hammer that crushes the rock into pieces. If you read the Bible, that's what it says. And the word of God is like fire that refines. The word of God is powerful. So people of God, in the interest of time, I am not going to say how you can apply the word of God, but how you can make it, how you can make the word of God work for you. Number one, read it. Number two,
Memorize it. Memorize the word. Put it in your head. And number three, meditate. When you meditate, you are now downloading that word from your head to the heart. You are now putting the word in your heart. And when you do that, when you meditate, personalize the word. Bring it closer to you. Personalize it. It say, this word is for me. It's speaking to me. Put your name there. Personalize the word. Bring it closer. And number five, visualize. Start to see pictures. Start to see yourself through the word of God. If you are not walking because of sickness, start to visualize. See yourself walking. See yourself doing what you could not do. See yourself. See yourself. See yourself through the word of God. And then when you visualize the word, number six, melodize the word of God. Start to compose a song upon what you believe in the word of God. Maybe you are believing for a healing. Start to search scriptures for healing, and you start to compose songs. By his stripes, I am healed. You compose a song. By his stripes, I am healed. 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 Then you visualize. You see yourself strong. You see yourself strong. People of God, believe the word. There is power in the word of God. Take the word, eat the word, read it, read it, read it, memorize, meditate, personalize, visualize, melodize the word of God. There is power in the word of God. If you are not feeling well, if you are not feeling well, start to search scriptures for healing. Search what you want in the word of God. Then you present your request through the word. Through the word. Not my understanding, my own understanding, but through the word of God. God bless you. Believe the word of God. Right now, as I pray, put the word of God into practice. There is power in the word of God. And learn to practice the word of God. Learn to practice. As our Father says, sometimes you need those scriptures that rebukes you. Don't shun them. Don't run away from them. Read them. When you read them, they are good for us. They are good for you. They will change us because the word of God has the ability for change in our lives. Father God, I thank you. In the name of Jesus, I bless your people. In the name of Jesus, as we continue to practice the word of God, as we abide in the word of God, we know when we abide in the word, when we obey your word, you will grant us our requests. In the name of Jesus. This afternoon, you are wiping tears for somebody.
in Jesus' name. Believe the word. Believe the word. Believe the word. Believe the word. You are not feeling well. Believe the word. Things are not right in your situation, in your life. Believe the word. Believe the word. Don't take it for granted. Believe it. 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 I believe. I know. I am speaking to somebody this afternoon. Believe it. Believe it. Believe it. There is power in the word of God. The Bible says the name of the Lord is our strong tower. The righteous will run into it and they are safe. We are safe in the name of the Lord. We are safe in the name of the Lord. We are safe in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Continue, Father, to cover your people. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Start to see yourself through the word of God. Through the word of God. Through the word of God. You are not a nobody. You are somebody. Through the word of God. You are a child of God. You are a child of God. You are the redeemed of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, you are not poor, but you are blessed. In the word of God, you are blessed, you are blessed, you are blessed. You are not the terror, but you are the head. Believe the word of God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the Bible says they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony. Father God, we trust in the blood of Jesus. We have victory in the blood of Jesus. Victory, victory, victory in the blood of Jesus. And we confess, we testify victory in Jesus' name. Victory in Jesus' name. We testify healthy, 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 healthy in the name of Jesus. As your word says, the sick shall say, I am healed. I am healed. I am healed. Confess the word. Believe the word. Believe it. 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 Don't say what the situation says. Say what the word of God says. Don't believe your situation. Don't believe your symptoms. Believe the word of God. Don't believe the symptoms of that sickness. Believe the word of God. The word of God. The word of God. The word of God. We are healed. We are strong. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the sick say, I am healed. Through the word of God, confess it in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon. Yeah, 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 yeah. I am giving you something to take home. Believe it, believe it, believe it, believe it. Have a firm foundation in the word of God, in the word of God. In Jesus' name, bless your people. Amen and amen. Thank you, Pastor Vunza.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you so much, powerful. We bless the name of the Lord. We thank you, Overseer, for such a profound delivery. God is a good God. It has been a wonderful Sunday, wonderful day. We want to leave this time back again to Sister Anesu. We want to put the word of God into practice. Sister Anesu, you may take over for this time.
Amen, amen. We thank God for what he's doing. We thank God for the word shared and the vessel God used. We just want to appreciate God through his servant he used today, as it is our norm. So please see the shared account details in which you can transfer your love gift. Host, if you can share account details for love gift. Yes, those are the details for the love gift. We just want to appreciate God for, you know, the word he shared through his servant. We know that this is our norm to just thank God, you know, by giving a love gift. So please see displayed account details. And Pastor Vunza, if I can just give the time back to you to just close us in prayer. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Overseer Gombakomba has prayed for us, blessed us. MC indicated, let's check the details of the account there. Bless the Lord. Bless God through his servant. It is good. It is good obeying the word of God. Thank you, MC. Thank you, prayer commander. Deacon Mary, thank you, praise and worship, the media team behind the scenes, thank you so much, and everyone, thank you for logging in. We may open our cameras, unmute, fellowship with each other for the little time that we have. Otherwise, we see you again next week, same time. See you in the morning. Morning glory, God of our Father, continue to watch over you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Overseer. Thank you, Pastor Bunda.
Thank you.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you for the powerful word. God bless you all. Have a wonderful week. Bye.
No press.
Thank you. God bless you.